here's the quickest and easiest way to make your own AI avatar. So if you ever dreamed of being a dragon slayer, a gladiator, a goth vampire man, or even in a Wes Anderson film, it's now entirely possible. I'm going to show you how to use this tool, how to get the most out of it, and even reveal some ways to create your own templates in the tool. Now, let's dive in and create our own dragon slaying gladiator extraordinaires together. Now, you can get up to 20 free photos every day for the first 7 days of signing up. All you have to do is come to Hyperbooth AI and you'll be asked to select the style of image that you would like. This is your opportunity to live out your fantasies and imagine yourself in a whole host of different worlds, environments, and situations. Now, you also have the option to completely define your own character, but we'll come onto that later. So for now, we're gonna go ahead and select one of these. I'm going to go with a game art assassin. There's nothing like being an assassin in life. I believe that one of the greatest skills in life is being able to be a shapeshifter. You need to be able to be a different character in many different situations. Now, what you have to do is upload a photo. Now, these are really important for getting a true likeness and an effective output. Let's run through exactly what you need. First of all, you need to have a frontal portrait. So that's like this, facing the camera, nothing like this. So next up, you make sure that there's only one person in the frame. It's also important not to have a small face. Now, if you have a naturally small face like mine, don't worry. Just make sure it's large in the shot. Now, you have to make sure not to cover your features. So if you wear sunglasses or a burqa, I recommend taking them off. It's also important to have a natural, neutral expression. And I recommend that you have a closed mouth and you're very focused on having a relaxed upper face area, especially around the eyebrows. Now, if you have a naturally unnatural expression, like a resting bitch face like mine, then you're going to have to slightly manipulate your own facial features to perform this process. And of course, please refrain from uploading any nudity to the system. So keep those nipples covered. So now you have these guidelines. You can select your photo. Here are a few photos that I've used that have worked well. You can see that they all have me facing forwards with a neutral, natural expression, and they don't have anyone else in the scene. So once you've selected the photo that you want to use, you can then select the aspect ratio. And this is essentially how wide and how tall your photo is, if it is a portrait or landscape. And I reckon most of the time you're going to be looking at a portrait style photo, especially if you're looking to share these across social media. So I'm gonna go with 3x4. Now, all we have to do is click on generate. What's great about Hyperbooth is that these generate exceptionally quickly. You also get 4 results at a time. And here we have it, the 4 different results. And you get these in different styles and different compositions. And you get these in different shots. So you get a close-up, a medium shot, and more of a full body shot. I particularly like this one. I would probably hire myself as an assassin. So now what you can do is you can download these by clicking on the download icon below each image. It'll open it in a new tab and download it directly to your machine. You can also like or dislike, and you're able to upscale these to HD. So currently these come out at 768 by 1024. Now, if you upscale, it doubles the size and you get a much higher definition version of your image. I quite like this war paint. Maybe I should get this done, tattooed on my face. Now, there are a number of other styles that you can try inside of Hyperbooth. Let me show you a few of my favorites. Here is corporate jet shot, me and my lovely jet. There are also artistic styles like this portrait sketch, which gives this sketched effect to your portraits. And you can also imagine yourself having a lovely church wedding. Everyone dreams of their white wedding day. Now, I particularly like the cyber metropolis shot. Here I am living my Blade Runner fantasies right out. I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Now, if you don't have a college degree, you can also mimic this and send it to your parents so they'll be proud of you. Now, what I particularly love about Hyperbooth is the ability to create your own prompts and scenarios. And it's very simple to do that. All you have to do is go to Try New Style and click on the first option, which is Create a Custom Style, where you can design your own styles using a prompt. This is a paid feature, but one I highly recommend. Now, let me show you some of the images that I've created using this. Here is me in a Wes Anderson film. I think this is my calling in life. I cannot believe I've not been cast yet. Wes, if you're watching, I'm ready for the call. Welcome to my office. I am Sir Samson Pimpernickel, and I will be your guide. I have the largest collection of bow ties this side of the Pyrenees. Now, you'll be able to download my free prompts in the description below, and these are a whole host of different prompts for extra themes that I think you're going to really enjoy. Here is me as a knight in the medieval times, ready for a jousting duel. You have brought dishonor upon my family, and for that you shall die. Here's something a little bit more casual, me being a little bit of a hipster living out in New York. And here is me as a very rich billionaire. Now, you might notice a little bit of a theme to some of the traits that I have selected. And that comes down to the fact that I've been reading a book called A Billion Wicked Thoughts, which was written by a pair of Google data analysts. And they sifted through a whole bunch of Google searches to decipher the most popular female fantasies. And it's quite intriguing, actually, what they came up with. Because the top five characters that women look for, the top five fantasies, the erotic situations that women have, are vampire, werewolf, billionaire, pirate, surgeon. Now, I also, me as a futuristic cosmonaut, everybody likes an astronaut. There's something about astronauts that is much like the adventurers of old, the final frontiers, of course, space. So to use these prompts in Hyperbooth, all you have to do is paste them into the text prompt bar. Now, you can also add in your own words and design your own prompts. And remember, you want to be specific here and add in some characteristic details of your character. Now, finally, you can upload your photo by clicking on the upload photo and finding it on your computer, or going to recent photos, and you'll be able to use ones that you've previously uploaded. Now, again, select the aspect ratio and go ahead and press generate. Now, one tip for using Hyperbooth is that if you don't like the results you get, you can regenerate them again. And every time you generate, they're going to be slightly different. So keep experimenting until you get ones that you like. Now, whilst that's loading, I'll show you a few other examples that I've created inside of my prompt book. Here is me living out my dragon fantasies, my dragon gladiator fantasies. And Baker, for all those baking goods. Now, I would imagine that Baker is probably the sixth most desirable fantasy for women. Can't keep your hands off of my buns. Now, there's also this style, which is imitating more of a Peaky Blinders style. So you can really emanate those characters. Now, I don't pay for microphones. My microphones are on the ass. Now, here's also me as a samurai. I have brought shame upon my... I've been watching that Shogun series recently. Highly recommended if you haven't seen it. And here is another style that I've created, and this is giving a TED talk. I think I certainly have an ambition one day to give my own TED talk, and this allows me to fantasize about it a little bit more deeply. But I'm not sure I'd wear such tight trousers. I'm curious, what styles are you going to try out? Let me know in the comments of what you would like to use Hyperbooth for. And here's the sexy hippie style. Let me tell you about crystals and star signs. I believe you're an Aries and I'm an Aquarius. Perfect match. And here is my vampire gothic style. I think this is pretty awesome. I think I need to get a nice velvet black suit like this and move to Transylvania. Time for blood. I think Hyperbooth is an incredibly easy and fast way to generate images using the likeness of a human being. It's very easy to use and requires very little technical knowledge. I particularly admire that it allows you to use a number of different templates as well as create your own. And remember, you can get access to my templates from the free prompt book in the description below. Now, you can also play about with using other people's images, but make sure you get permission to use them first. Here is a woman that I've been playing around with and conceptualizing her in different scenarios. So this is great if you're creating some storyboards or story works and you want to try out different actors and actresses in the role. Here she is as an attractive detective. And here's a beautiful, enchanting elf from the forest, if you were looking to make a Lord of the Rings remake. And also here is the woman as a rather empowering dystopian heroine. And of course, how could we not have her as a baker? Every man's favorite dream is a woman who bakes beautiful buns. And a studious writer crafting away in her library, writing the next best-selling crime thriller. So Hyperbooth is a quick and easy way to generate characters with consistent features. So create your first AI photo using Hyperbooth AI. And remember to check out my free prompt book in the description below. Thank you very much for watching. It's a pleasure to have you here. And I'm also very curious what you thought of this video. If you have any feedback for me, I'm very grateful for any thoughts on how you think I can improve the quality of my videos. Anything from production value to my presentation to delivery. And of course, if there are some things that you really enjoyed, I appreciate hearing what did you enjoy? What did you learn? What was entertaining for you? Thanks very much for being here. And most of all, I wish you a most delightful day.